PEGI 16.
Sega.
One was a bit of a covert project for EA.
They
didn't know that they were funding it.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm serious, they didn't kind of know they were doing it. We weren't even going to do Shogun to start with. We were going to do a role-playing game based on Monkey. We were starting doing work on Monkey. We started doing a design, and we got some prototypes together, and then Command & Conquer came out. We looked at that and thought, no, this is easy. We could do this. We could do it really quickly. Much easier than doing a role-playing game based on Monkey.
That's why when I started at the office, there were all these Monkey books all over the place, and I couldn't figure out why.
The battles on their own didn't have enough gameplay to stand up as a game on their own, it needed something else, either some strategy putting into the battles like other RTSs or a wrapper around them, we went for the wrapper option.
Also narrative as well, because a battle in itself is nothing. I mean, it was just kind of shallow in a way. Whereas the campaign also gives you a narrative,
you write your own story.
The biggest appeal for me when I got really big time into medieval was that I always loved history, and this was a chance for me to actually change history and kind of
so
alter
Poland
it.
Can win this time.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, Poland did win. Now we dominated the world. In my world,
you dominated all the world of Poland.
The whole world. The whole world was Poland. Europe was just, it was amazing. It was just, I could change history, sculpt it as I wanted it. And it was just, it was great. That's the main thing for me. I mean, it's very general, but that's what appealed to me the most.
I guess, though, the thing about Medieval was, it was the first, I mean, Shogun established the whole thing, but Medieval was the first breakaway hit for the series, wasn't it? Like, it really kind of sold and got into homes and got into minds.
It's probably easier content for some people.
It's easier content for a lot of Western people, because you've already... You don't have to sell the whole sort of Robin Hood night.
No, everybody understands that.
You kind of know...
But, you see, this is the argument of the familiar versus the cool. Right, because the theme of Shogun, although people aren't always familiar with the history, it's incredibly cool. It's an incredibly interesting period.
Yeah. Everybody
right?
likes it when you explain, he's samurai and ninjas,
right?
And big swords.
But
and
the
all that sort
but
of
the medieval period, oh, wow, yeah. The medieval period is immediately accessible because it is common history for pretty much every nation in Europe. You know, and even the Americans
North
have
America,
a vague
yeah,
idea.
The North American history is essentially European.
European
history
right? Exactly. Before the Exodus. As
Yeah, medieval history is far more insane than Japanese history.
People are kind of enthused about the whole idea of doing medieval history because they thought they loved
it. It was awesome. That was where I came into it.
Me too.
Total War game. It was the first one I came into.
That's when I realised.
Still
my
favourite period of history.
Exactly.
So medieval was all about taking what we'd done with Shogun and making it perfect. So it was all about evolution. It was about taking each different area of the game and just pushing it forward and taking it as far as it could go with that engine. When we started on Med 1, we also started on Rome at the same time. So the whole idea was that we'd do an evolution and a revolution in parallel.
The problem is that doing history about Rome was that you were essentially trying to reconstruct the resistance from Gestapo reports.
Yeah.
You've only got the Roman side of it, so they're going, these guys are nutcases. Look at them, they're 18 feet tall with a single eye and they can spit fire.
Yeah, they say un-PC things.
Yeah, and they're appalling.
It's actually quite good for us, you know.
Yeah, but we also know that it's palpable nonsense that these guys weren't 18 feet tall.
We should literally take that.
The idea of Rome, though, was revolutionary. The idea was we didn't want somebody else to be the team that beat us.
We had to be our own beaters.
So we set up a second team and said, okay, you beat us.
I think the campaign map was definitely felt very different.
Yeah, so it went from region-based to grid-based campaign. Full 3D on the troops.
I like the idea though of having your own competition in house.
Yeah.
Like, because I mean, every studio always says, "Oh, we've got to do the best and beat ourselves," kind of thing. But actually, by having two teams and having them looking over each other's shoulders, and going, "Well, actually, did a better job than you," so meh. Okay, you've got everybody. We talk to them about the original games. They always mention the Holy Trinity. Okay, you've got Shogun 1, Medieval 1, and Rome. Mm-hmm. Right, and everybody talks about those as the golden years of when they came in.
But
and their youthful
memory. It's like comics. They're always going to be the golden.
But Rome
years.
Doesn't fit. Of no, those three things, no, Rome doesn't different. Fit. Rome yeah. is utterly different to the first two.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right, and yet it has this universal appeal, which
it's
is either
the
down to theme or
it's the
right.
Subject. Yeah. It's the subject.
And it's a best-selling
everybody
as well.
Seems
well, no, it's not just the subject. It is actually an excellent game.
It is, no, yeah. it is genuinely yeah.
a
great
game. And it was a first.
It's
as
another
well.
One
it was
where
more of a first
you say to somebody, you are Caesar, and they instantly go, oh, Spartacus, Caesar. And in Cleopatra, you know it kind yeah. of already, you know, pyramids.
Yeah.
Swords and sandals.
Swords and sandals.
Swords and sandals. There was a wave of swords.
And there was,
a,
and there was a hot, we were lucky because movies like Gladiator hit.
Yeah, yeah,
around the same
yeah.
time.
And but it, also, it was so much more of a jump than any other game. It was so much newer and bigger and better than any other game
oh,
at the time.
Big in Shogun,
so it was,
yeah.
So, yeah, so that's what it was. I mean, Shogun was a little genre kind of bending.
There
kind
were
of
some really
I mean, at the time when Rome came out, there was nothing else quite like it.
No, true,
it,
that's
you know,
true.
Of the, yeah. that scale. I mean, you look at Shogun, you look at anything, it looks kind of like a geeky kind of niche game, but you look at Rome and you think Hollywood. You know, yeah. it's that's what
yeah.
it was.
Yeah.
You know, mm. and that's what.
There was a deliberate effort to squeeze yeah. Hollywood into it.
To squeeze Hollywood into the game, yeah.
Epic was the.
Epic was the word.
By
yeah,
way, that was the word for
Dominatus.
No. It was for Rome. It was Imperator.
Empire was a fun one because that's where I came in. Mm. And I remember coming into Empire. And I've worked on other software projects and bits and pieces before. But I remember coming into Empire and seeing it. And it was the first time. It was literally like, you know, kind of walking into Willy Wonka's chocolate factory. And because I remember, you know, having played all the games, been a massive fan and everything else, and then kind of coming through the doors and wondering how sausages are made.
Yeah,
it was an interesting experience, and it was definitely a real eye-opener to come in and to see something like that, I think, with Empire.
Shattered.
Well, Empire was definitely the biggest, most ambitious thing that we've attempted.
We were mental.
But
not only in period and scope, but also the fact that we were rewriting everything from scratch.
And we added in.
Is that we almost wanted every challenge in the book?
We added a third game.
Oh, let's add naval battles as well.
Yeah, yeah. Then we add the naval games. Battles, yeah.
And let's do it in half the time of Rome.
I think that's one of the things that people don't necessarily appreciate. We actually make three games.
We do, yeah. Yes.
We make the campaign map, that's a game. We make the battles, that's a game. And the naval battles, that's a game as well.
Frankly, the UI is quite fun as well.
Yeah.
Technically, truthfully, you could also count the multiplayer as a game on its own. Although it's using those game modes, but
more so now.
Shogun 2 multiplayer.
It's a completely separate.
Definitely, but that's just
it's the fourth game.
Yeah.